Hey guys, it's Harold. We're back, and let's see, what are we at? We are at 98 degrees Celsius. Boilers, there's 99. Boilers getting us ever so closer to getting to 100%, 100 degrees C where it'll actually start generating steam. Oh, there it is. Here comes the steam. 100 at 101 degrees C, it really kicked in.
Well, if that's thundering out, I better get a move on finishing this off.
Oh.
Don't want to get struck. Go away. This is my territory now. Beat it.
I'm just doing an insert Jeopardy music here while we wait for the boiler to get enough steam to actually put steam into the tank.
Working on my roof right now.
Okay.
Not exactly the most joyous thing to do during a thunderstorm.
Nope.
And this is the point where I realize, hey, dumbass, you put the roof one block too low. Well, I'm really screwing this up today. as trying to pay too much attention to the mobs and not enough attention to what I was doing.
Good job.
Your remote chests. Oh, geez. First chest I look at, Certus Quartz. Do you need the yellow right ore?
No. I was going to give that to you earlier, but
Distractions.
yeah.
Steel sword.
Take all the steel stuff. I don't haven't had much luck in smelting it.
Okay. Even if it's using nothing but storage buses on your existing chests, an ME system would be golden for you right about now, wouldn't it?
As I said, let me worry about my setup here. Resources, I don't mind sharing, but when it comes to the actual tech, I'm trying to do that on my own here. You understand, right?
Yeah. Hello, zombies. Turn around.
What?
I'm trying to get into your backpack.
Why is that?
Because I ended up with some of your smooth stone. Like almost a stack of it.
Maybe you should put take a bit of dirt and jump up on it.
There.
That didn't damage the wall, did it?
Nope. Check out the precision. Check out the precision on that divot. Oh,
Here.
man. Oh.
That's a divot bomb right there.
Oh, the precision on it, though. now that I'm back, I should actually have enough steam in that tank to turn on the grinder for... Oh, yeah. Tank's full.
Oh yeah, remember us telling you about that Groundhog Day thing before?
Yeah.
I went back and reread some of the older ones, and there was a really funny prank written about what Ranma did to most of Narnia.
Okay.
What he did was he got really bored and he decided to... he's paying attention to Kasumi and realized that nobody ever paid much attention to her because she is, by and large, not somebody that there was anything to pay attention about.
Yeah.
So what he did was he trained a lizard in order to jump out at her at the wrong time because she hated lizards.
Uh-oh.
Then she trained, or not she, he trained Godzilla, or rather a Godzilla-type creature, to head straight to the Tendo Dojo. This creature that was trained, as soon as a certain condition was met, would fly backwards, because it was enchanted. Like, it was a magical construct.
Okay.
So so you can see where this is going.
Mm-hmm.
It wreaked havoc, running all the way through Tokyo, straight to the dojo. And then, just after it stuck its nose in the front door, it went flying backwards suddenly. Kasumi sticks her head out and says, "Is the lizard gone?" Can you picture that?
Oh my god. The elaborateness of that. Someone was bored.
Well, the thing is, most of these loopers have been looping for so long, it takes a lot for them to get interested in anything, really. So, inevitably, they end up in these massive prank wars.
Yeah.
Naruto's still looking over his back after a certain incident. What he was going to do was simply, during the Star Wars Clone Wars, he was going to have, instead of, what's his name cloned? Boba Fett's father?
Jango,
yes. He was going to have Ranma cloned. Needless to say, things didn't quite go as planned.
Yeah.
What happened was, just during the time that the shuttle he was on was taking off, he finally confessed what the plan was to Sasuke. Sasuke made a comment that it wasn't going to work, that Ranma was going to find out, and it would somehow blow up in his face. Naruto said, "Don't worry, it's going to take him a long time to figure out I had anything to do with this. What can possibly go wrong?" At that moment, Sakura sticks her head in the room and says, "What can go wrong with what?" Naruto jumps and screams like a small child. Sasuke looks at Naruto and says, "Well, congratulations, I didn't know payback came back at light speed."
Yeah. Oh, there we go. That's good.
What Sakura did was she reprogrammed all the clones so that there would be male and female versions, and that they eliminated the no fraternization portion.
Yeah. Anyway, I got my rotary craft grinder started. And probably making an excessive amount of steam for just one grinder, but whatever.
No such thing as too much. There's only open fire and I need to reload.
Pretty much. See what's my power consumption. Oh man. I could run my current base's consumption off of four magmatic dynamos. Just what's going on right now. Oh man, I'm somewhere in the overkill class for power right now.
Well, don't forget what's going to happen once I get my bees going.
Power supply problems? What's that? Right?
Bee power, literally. I wonder what Flora would think.
I know what
Jaded Cat.
I know what Sengir would think.
Nerf time! Nerf time!
Yep.
That's not right! That's not right!
lava. Let's take 4 tanks of worth of lava over. You said you were having trouble melting down the steel gear into stuff you can actually use?
I don't need it myself, but I was just trying to melt it down so I could get rid of it.
So you could stash it as ingots?
Effectively, yes.
Because there is machinery down the road.
Creeper! Creeper! Go away! You die now!
Not my fault! Yeah, I'm going to be able to get ingots out of those steel pieces. One way or another.
Even if you need to convert them to iron and then convert them to steel.
Even if, yeah. Admittedly, I probably don't, because I've got this crucible furnace that's taken it down that actually actively lists molten steel, 288 millibuckets, which is 2 ingots for the sword. And otherwise properly proportioned numbers for the other pieces, like the chest pieces and leggings. Oh, yeah. I had a lava flow that I was working on down in the bowels that I probably actually drained.
Okay, short of quite clear glass, this section is essentially enclosed.
Nice.
Just doing the last finishing touches on the roof. A few more bricks. Then torches. Then onto the glass. Then I can decide what I want for the floor.
Yeah.
I'm thinking a wood of some kind. Give it a really nice library type feel to it. A few unnecessary bookcases here and there. That should do it, right?
Yeah. And that's basically at that point, machinery-wise, I just hit the 30-minute mark somewhat recently, but we're not doing too bad for time, just got a couple of spots here that I want to, that I will want to harvest from shortly. And you know you want a lot of silk touch in a big area when you're considering making a hammer that has silk touch.
True. This is true.
Yep, this lava pool is definitely bigger than I bargained for. Oh well.
Your eyes are bigger than your tank?
I don't know yet.
Interesting.
Oh?
If the exact moment you get water breathing is the precise moment one of those water bubbles disappears, you know, when it's popping?
Yeah.
It will freeze at that point. Trespasser. Okay, you poured it out. Where did you go? I can hear you buzzing around. Where are you? Where are you? My fortress is large enough for you to still be in here. Where did you go? There you are. Hiding in the new wing, are you? Bugger. You buggered. You deserved what I gave you.
Let's see, how did this go? Still coming up to temperature that, so.
Why doesn't this keep going?
What?
My alloy smelter. Oh, that's wrong mode. Why is that putting you out just regular glass? There's some quite clear glass. Might be it. Got power, what are you complaining about?
That's grinding it. Basically full speed.
Okay, there we go. That's better.
Oh?
I have no idea why it was behaving the way it was. It produced some glass first, and that wouldn't keep running. It turned out something was going on with one of its settings.
Anyway, YouTube, I'm going to catch you guys next time, because, you know, it's that time of the episode, and then some. Anyway, later.